categories of functions in C language. What we are going to discuss in this video? We are going to discuss what is a function, what is the prototype of the function, and what are the categories of functions in C language. See, what is a function? Function is a collection of statements designed to do a specific task. So the function can execute independently. A function can be executed independently, or it can be called by any other function, or a function can call any other function. A function can be called by any other function, or a function can call any other function n number of times. If a function is calling by itself, it is called as recursion. Self-calling is called as recursion. For more information on functions, you please refer my previous video, Functions in C Language. The link is provided in the following description box. What is a function prototype? Function prototype indicates function name, number of parameters, type of parameters, order of parameters, and return type. Function name is to refer that name. For example, your parents have given a name to you. What is the purpose of your name? It is to identify a person. It is to communicate with a person. We are using the name. In the same way, to make a communication with the function, we use function name. And the parameters, function name, parameters, and return type, all together we call it as prototype, function prototype. You see. Syntax, return type, function name, within the open brackets, give the parameters, and don't give the semicolon after function header in the definition part. After that, function body starts. In the body of the function, you write whatever the statements you want in the function body. So we write the statements to perform some actions like program. And last executable statements of function must be return statement. Return returns the control to the calling location. For example, consider small example, fagint. Int is return type. When you call the function int, it returns integer type. Function name is fact. Function name is fact. Parameter is n is of type integer. You see, function name fact, number of parameters 1, type of parameters and order of parameters. This is regarding formal parameters. Parameters which are in function definition are known as formal parameters. Formal parameters, number of parameters 1, type of parameter integer, order of parameter as it is only 1 integer parameter. Next, this is return type. Okay, this is called as function prototype or function signature. Function prototype or function signature. What is the function name? What is the return type? What is the number of parameters, type of parameters, and order of parameters? So these I and F are called as local variables. So I am finding the factorial of n. So I is 1 and F is 1. I is 1, I is less than, or just I am using the for loop to find the factorial, like 4 into 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into up to n minus 1 into n. It returns F. For more information on factorial, you please refer my previous video, functions on C language, functions in C language. Now you see the categories of function. This is the important categories of functions. Functions are categorized into 4 types based upon the prototype, with argument, with return, without argument, with return, without argument, without return, with argument, with return. in this with argument with return is the most regular model, but you can use any of the signature. Total four models with argument with return, with argument with return. A function which accepts some arguments and returns some value, this is known as with argument and with return. It accepts some parameters. While a function is calling, we need to pass some parameters. In response, it returns some value, like factorial function. In the previous model, previous example, we have discussed factorial model. Int fact in open brackets int n. Here that number of parameters, one, return type is integer type. Okay, you see the signature is like this: return type, function name, data type or parameters, you write the statements, at last you write the return, function call, function name. You see here my function is stdio.h conio.h, it is okay, factorial of n. You see return type, this is with return, return type is integer, my function name is fact, and arguments x is my argument. Okay, this is my function signature, return type, function name with parameter, this, because this is with argument with return. You see, with argument, with return, with argument, with return. If you understand this concept, it will be easy. With return, with argument. Return type is integer, with argument, one argument, that is of type integer. I can write any number of arguments. Now I am writing the code. Within the function body, I need to write I am going to find factorial of n, so I am writing I as local variable and f as local variable, initialized with 1, because your multiplicative inverse is 1, so I am initializing f with 1. I am using the for loop to find the factorial of n. Just instead of adding the n numbers, we are multiplying them and adding them to the total. I is 1, I is less than or equals to x. Because here my fact, here my formal parameter is x, so I am writing x. I is incremented by 1 every time. F is multiplied by I. Return f. At last it returns f value. Now the function block is completed. Function block is completed. This is function body. Function body completed. After completion of this for loop, the control returns to the function calling location and it returns value f. Now, this function definition should be above the main function. It should not be within the main body. It should be above the main, or after the main function also, after the main block also we can write. But it is better to write function definition above the main, so it will be easy for the compiler. Next, I am writing the local variables of main program. N and factorial are my two variables. Just n is to read the value from the user. Factorial is to represent the result. CLRS here, it is to clear the screen. Enter n value, printf message. It prints the message. Enter value to find factorial. Scanf, it is to read the n value. Just here, I am calling the function. Here, I am calling the function. Function name, parameter. At the time of calling, I need not to mention the return type. Just I pass the function name. Within the function name, I pass the arguments as per the format of function definition. You call it as prototype. Prototype. As it returns factorial of n value, so I am storing it in factorial, I am assigning it to factorial. For example, in the scanf, if I pass 4, 4 will be stored in n. Automatically, fact of n, the control will be moved to factorial definition, fact definition. Now the x will be replaced by, now control will be moving like this. Control will be coming this. So n is, x is replaced by n. And n is replaced by 4. That means whenever we are, now whenever we are using the word letter x, automatically it means 4. In the same way, if I pass 5, n is, x is replaced by n, n is 5. Like that it will consider. For any number, I can find factorial. Now if I pass a fact of n, where n is 4, how many times this loop get execute, this for loop? 4 times. This for loop executes 4 times. So it will calculate like this. First time I value is 1. 1 into 1. Second time I value is 2. 1 into 2. Whatever it got into 3. Into 4. 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, 24. That will be stored in F. Whenever the control is returning at the end of the block, it will return. After completion of this loop block, it will return. So it will return 24. It will return 24. So factorial value will be 24. So if I give the printf statement, factorial of percentage d is percentage d. First percentage d, n. N is 4. In this example, n is 4. Factorial value. What is factorial value? Factorial value is 24. Factorial value is 24. So it will print factorial of 4 is 24. Factorial of 4 is 24. Like that it will print. Get CH, it is to hold the output screen. So this will be the sample output. Okay, you can run it for 4, 5, etc. Next model. With argument, with return. Sorry, without argument, with return. Now we have completed with return, with argument. Next one is without argument, with return. That means a function which does not receive any argument but returns some value. We are not passing any arguments to the function. But whenever you are calling that function, it is returning some value. You see the signature. It is not accepting any arguments, but it is returning some value. It is not accepting any arguments. Formal parameters empty. But it is returning some value. You call it as without argument with return. This is return type. Return type. In this example, I am writing a return type integer. Okay. For example, if you want to find area of a circle, pi r square, pi value. Pi value is fixed. So I am writing a function to return the pi value. Every time instead of defining, I am writing pi function. So you see, float, pi value. What is pi value? Generally, we are using 3.14. 3.14 is a real number. In C language, real number is denoted with float data type. So my return type is float. My function name is pi. Is it taking any arguments? No, it is not taking any arguments. So my function name is float. Sorry, my function name is pi. Return type is float. And it is not accepting any parameters. Just I am writing float p equal to 3.14 return p. Simple function. A function which does not accept any parameters but returns some value. Call it as without argument. Without argument with return. Okay, in this case, my function pi does not accept any argument but returns float data type. Next, void main int r. Just I am taking r radius to read r value. Float a, enter radius value, read r value. After reading r value, I am storing the pi r square formula. pi r square, pi, just I am calling the function name, not passing any arguments, but it returns pi value. What is pi value in this case? 3.14. So whenever a function calls, it returns CC. Whenever a function calls, it like this, control will move to function definition. In response, it returns p value. P value is 3.14. It returns 3.14. So whatever r value I enter, for example, if I enter r value as 2, it will make it as 3.14 into, if I give r value as 2, it will give 2 into 2. Okay, 2 into 2 2 square 4 4 into 3.14, some 12 point something like that it will get. If I give r value 3, it will give 3 into 3 9 9 into 3.14, like that it will calculate. After completion of the function, the return statement returns the control to the calling location. Now you see area of cell, just I am printing it in the 6.2f format, total 6 digits, to after a decimal point 2 digits will be printing. Okay, next we move to without argument, without return. So this is third case, not passing any argument and not returning any value. Still now we have discussed two models, with argument, with return. Second model is without argument, with return. Now third model, without argument, without return. It does not accept any parameters, at the same time it does not return any value. You call it as without argument, without return. It performs some task, function performs some task, but it does not accept any argument. At same time, it does not accept any parameters. So here key point, as it is not returning anything, don't leave it blank. If you leave it blank, return type, if you leave it blank, it will be considered it as int. Don't think that as it is not returning anything, you need not to write anything. You have to return keyword void. Void. Void means nothing. If function return type is left empty, blank, it will consider it as int. So that's why you have to write keyword void. Void means nothing. Return type void. We have used void n number of times, even in the main function also. We have used void. Return type void means does not return anything. Don't leave it blank. My next function name, you write some, don't write any parameter, because this is without argument, without return. Okay. Now is simple. We can consider some line example. If I want to print any line, I am writing this function. Conny.h, void line, you see. I am not passing any argument, not returning any argument, but it performs some task. Just this function, just I am writing a function to print a line with special symbols. Generally, every line consists of 80 columns in computers. Every line consists of 80 columns. So I am printing same symbol 80 times side by side. Automatically, it will form a line. Here I have used underscore, underscore symbol, slash symbol, dollar symbol, any symbol I can use. Just I am printing the same symbol 80 times like this. It will print 80 times. So what is this function? You see, I is local variable. I is 0, I is less than 80, I plus plus. First time it will print one underscore symbol like this. Here I am writing one underscore symbol like this. Next time I value is 1. Next time it will print I one more symbol like this. The next time I value is 2, it will print underscore symbol like this. How many times it repeats? It will repeat it up to 80 times. So it will write 79, 80 like that it will print. After completion, it will come back to the next line. abr my local variable just to perform some addition operation like that. Enter two numbers. I am calling line function. You see, line function with not passing any argument, not returning anything. Whenever line function is there, control will be moved to line function definition. Now you see, CLRSR line means it will print line. What it will print with this underscore symbols, it will print one line. After that, it will print enter two numbers. After this message, again it will print one more line. Scanf, it accepts two numbers. Again it print line. Again it add the numbers and print the sum. Again it print the lines. All lines will be printing with the same symbols. Same symbols. You see, difference. Like performing your calculator operations. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, like this. Again print. You see, here I have called this line function how many times? One time, two times, three times, four times, five times, six times. But the definition I have given it only one time. Six times I have not defined this line function. This is the major advantage of function. Reusability. I have written the code to print line one time. But in this program only I have used it six number of times. You can define function one time and you can use it n number of times. In this case, I have used it six times so that I can save my time. I can save my memory. Getch, it is to hold the screen. The same function with argument without return. Just in this case, we pass one argument but it does not return any value. Same for line function can be modified. You see. We are passing one argument, but it does not return any time. We call it as with argument without return. Same line function with a little bit modification. You see, return type is void, but here my formal parameter is x. X is of type character. I can write any number of parameters. Just I am taking one example. In the previous example, or in all the line functions, we have printed same symbol. Instead of printing same symbol, each line I can use different symbol. For example, one line I can use underscore. In another line, I can use @ symbol. Another line, I can use slash symbol. Another line, I can use star symbol, like that. Only the difference is it accepts some parameters. It does not return anything. So instead of printing the symbol underscore directly, we use %c. We use %c and print the character. %c character. You see, %cx. Instead of printing the underscore symbol, it print x value. Instead of printing underscore symbol, fixed underscore symbol, it print x value. So in the function call, I pass the argument because I need to pass one argument that is of type character. You see, first line function. See here. Here I have passed @ symbol. That means first line will be printed with @ symbol. Enter two numbers. Second line will be printed with dollar sign. That means this x is replaced by @ first time. X is replaced by dollar first time. X is replaced by dollar sign. Next time X is replaced by dollar sign. Like that it will change. I can use it n number of times. Now third line, I am using star symbol. Add the exclamatory marks. Fourth line will be exclamatory mark. Next will be plus sign. Whatever the symbol you want, you can use symbol. But at the time of passing, remember that you need to pass character variable if you are passing the symbol enclosed within single quotation. Enclosed within single quotation, because character is should be enclosed within single quotation. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.